How quickly can you get started with your astronomy session? I've been loving my SkyWatcher SolarQuest because I've been able to get started with my solar astronomy sessions extremely quickly. But I wanted to time myself and see exactly how fast I can get going. I only tested how quickly I can get going visually and not how quickly I can get started imaging because of my plans to do solar outreach in the near future, which will be mostly visual. And before I got started, I took the entire thing apart, including the accessory tray from the tripod. So let's see how long it took me. This is going at 500% speed, and I brought just about everything outside with me. Everything here is set up from scratch, including the accessory tray and balancing of the tripod. And after I installed my telescope, I realized that I forgot my power tank, so I had to run in and get that, and that added about 70 seconds to my setup time. And of course, I forgot to really turn it on for another 20 seconds. But once I turned it on, it actually found the GPS signal extremely quickly, and I was able to get started with my session. So that took about 4 minutes and 50 seconds, which includes the 70 seconds it took me to go find my power tank and the other 20 seconds before I realized that I didn't turn on the SolarQuest. So if you subtract the 90 seconds where I kind of wasted time, the total setup took about 3 minutes and 20 seconds, which is incredibly fast. And as I mentioned, the SolarQuest found the GPS signal very quickly. As you saw, it took mere seconds. Normally it takes 2 to 3 minutes to find the GPS signal, but for some reason that day it was extremely fast. During the partial eclipse on October 14th, it took the SolarQuest almost 10 minutes to find a GPS signal. My guess is that the thick clouds may have interfered with it, or I did have a lot of other electronics running around the SolarQuest that could have interfered. But 10 minutes was pretty frustrating, but eventually it found a signal and I was able to get going. And once I was set up, I looked through my 12mm eyepiece, which I found is the sweet spot for the 140, and I noticed that there were about 10 or so prominences that I could see with my eyes. I don't think I've ever seen that many visually with my eyes through a telescope or have even imaged it. So of course I had to run in and grab my laptop and my camera, and at that time I was still using my ASI 120mm mini camera, so I had to do a 2-panel mosaic to fit the whole sun into the images that you'll see. This quick video here is just the top part of the sun. I took about 1,000 frames and I stacked 400 of them. And here is the bottom half of the sun, not the bottom half, the bottom part of the sun, which was then mosaiced onto the top half, also took 1,000 frames and I stacked 400 of them. I then processed the two parts separately in auto stackered, and then I moved it into Photoshop to do a mosaic manually. Once I had a single TIFF file to work with, I moved that into IMPPG. And this time I used IMPPG over Astrosurface because I realized that the tone curve adjuster works wonderfully for prominences around the sun. Much better than Astrosurface, which means that I don't have to process the prominences separately and then add them back in. I can just do the whole thing in one go. And when you look at the image coming out of IMPPG, you'll notice that there are some Newton rings, and that's because I didn't take any flats during my imaging session. And I did end up having some stacking artifacts. It's probably with some of the frames coming out of AutoStacker, so I could look for those, get rid of them, or stack fewer frames and see if that makes a difference. But for now, I'm pretty happy with what I have. After I was done with IMPPG, I took it back out and put it into Photoshop so that I could do the colorization. And this is the final result. If anyone is interested in a processing video of this, let me know. I will be happy to make one. And as always, I wish you all clear skies. Kitty says hi.